The 11 News I team has been working to learn more about the shooter and what led up to Saturday's violence. So far, very little known about Darion Aguilar that stands out. I team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live in Columbia with that part of the story. Jane.
Donna, motive, of course, is what everyone is looking for. What it really is a search for something to make sense. By all accounts, 19-year-old Darion Aguilar was a young man who stayed under radar. No criminal record, little trace of him on social media. So what fed his very public act of violence Saturday morning? When police and witnesses say he took a pistol-grip shotgun to the Columbia Mall and used it to kill 21-year-old Brianna Benlolo and her co-worker Tyler Johnson inside the Zumi skate shop where both victims were employed. We've now learned Aguilar fired 4 shots that hit the victims and at least 2 other shots before shooting and killing himself.
Your frustrations, believe me, I'm asking the chief the same questions every hour. The chief's asking the detectives the same questions on an ongoing basis.
We've learned new details about Aguilar's background. His mother filed for divorce from his father in Prince George's County Court in November, but the two had been separated since 1999 when Darion was just 4. He has a 20-year-old sibling. Aguilar attended Four Seasons Elementary in Anne Arundel County from 2004 to 2006. He went to Arundel Middle School for the 2006-2007 school year. For 5 years, the Aguilar family lived on a quiet Silver Spring cul-de-sac. The neighborhood is off Route 29, about 15 miles from the Columbia Mall. For the past year, the Aguilars lived in College Park, where Darion worked at a nearby Dunkin' Donuts. That house is just 4 blocks from the College Park home of victim Brianna Benlolo. Investigators are checking whether that allowed shooter and victim in any way to cross paths before Saturday's shooting. A Montgomery County gun dealer today said that Aguilar paid $430 cash for that 12-gauge pistol-grip shotgun from his shop in December. The dealer said there was no reason to suspect anything was wrong. He was polite. He had another person with him, another man, the dealer said. Both were polite and very pleasant at the time of the gun purchase. The dealer said Aguilar told him he needed the gun for home protection for he and his mother. Reporting live tonight from Columbia, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.